people that don't know you, would you like to introduce yourself, please?
I'm Ade Solanke. I'm a writer. I write plays. I write screenplays. I write now. My first novel is on its way. So I'm a storyteller. To do with my experience as a child growing up in the UK.
Yeah.
It's all about when I do it. Mm-hmm. I usually try to do it first thing in the morning. Mm-hmm. But the only thing that I must do every day is write my daily quota of scenes.
Yeah. So what inspired you to become a playwright?
That's a good question. I think I was someone who always was interested in human beings.
Yeah.
And at the same time, I was also interested in words. So my work is basically words about human beings, and I'm interested in characters and the mystery of human personality, why people behave as they do, what makes people function, tick. Theatre. I've been writing theatre for about 6 years.
Yeah.
And I've actually written about 7 plays.
Uh-huh.
And Pandora's Box, which is on at Luton Carnival Arts tonight and is on its national tour, as you know.
Yeah.
We've been all around the country.
Yeah, I saw the list.
As far as Newcastle. I'd never been to Newcastle. It was just, I looked at the map and I thought, what did I think I was doing? So I've been to Bradford, Leeds, Liverpool, Manchester, we've been all over. And now we're actually starting our London tour this week. And Luton is our final regional day. And this was my first play.
Yeah.
So I'm really excited and happy that it's been supported to have a national tour. Since then, I've written 6 other plays. And I have a reading of another play. My latest play is on at the end of this month at Rich Mix, which is my first historical drama.
Wow.
All my other pieces have been contemporary. So I'm now doing the historical drama.
That's good.
It's a comedy. It's about a serious issue. As you know, we have some really excellent, successful young people, fortunately for us. But also there are some young people who aren't so comfortable with their lives here, not necessarily doing so well in education. And sometimes the parents, if they're from Africa or the Caribbean, say, well, let's take them back home, see how they get on. So the play is about a mother who has a son who's challenging, having a challenging time, and she thinks, well, maybe he'll be better off in Nigeria. So it's about whether or not is the right thing for her to do, and how it affects her relationship with him and with the people around her. It is quite a feat, actually. It takes a lot of organisation, and I'm actually mainly a writer, but I've become a producer because, like many writers, I have an idea of how I want the show to be and to look and go. So I said, oh, let me try and do it myself.
Mm-hmm.
And we had to audition, we had to then make decisions and cast, and we had to get production people and stage managers, and it was a lot of work. It takes a lot of time, actually. So the play is about 3 generations of a family.
Yeah.
So we've got 3 generations of different ages of performer.
Yeah.
So that's been really nice, seeing them all work together, communicate across 3 or 4 decades of experience. We have so many talented actors in this country, we're very lucky. My main priority is always to just get the audience to enjoy a really good story, well told. That's my priority. And luckily, somehow, fortunately, we've really seemed to have succeeded in really connecting with audiences. You've seen the feedback on the website.
Yeah.
We have so much wonderful support, media praise, etc. So I'm just really glad that we've been able to connect and share some of the ideas and some of the passion we have for storytelling.
Yeah.
Now, the next stage is, we've had the London production, now the national tour. The next stage is the West End, or a film, and or both. The audience award is a key one. When you hear a crowd of people
cheering.
But they're not cheering me, they're cheering the actors who are just performing.
Yeah.
When they get a standing ovation, you say to yourself, that's a great prize, that's an award for me. Especially when I see children. You know, as a child, growing up in the UK, we didn't really go to theatre. We didn't feel that we were welcome in certain spaces. So I'm really happy that I'm part of that process of changing that openness of the arts world for audiences of all complexions, of all backgrounds. So that's another reward and award for me, to see venues bringing in, embracing African Caribbean audiences.
Yeah.
And many venues are seeing the value of widening their participation. We're really happy about that. But yes, the awards from my peers, when we were nominated for Best New Play, the Off West End Awards, that was a real lovely accolade. because it's from the other people who are working in my sector, and I felt extremely privileged to have that honour. You know, I've been really blessed that Pandora'sBox has connected so well, and people are now aware of the kind of work, and I hope the quality of work that I aim to always provide.
Yeah.
So the next thing is a new play, but also this story has connected, has resonated so deeply. I think we'll work on a film. I think that's definitely an offer that we can make to audiences. So people don't have to come to the theatre, they can get, you know, the DVD, come to the cinema and really enjoy that. Because I think what we've shown, and not just myself but other writers, is that there's a real audience for African work, for you know, the stories that we want to tell. And they haven't been told, so it's a great untold story. I arrived, we come into this space, the audience is having a great time.
Mm-hmm.
For me, that's what it's all about. Yeah. Great stories, well told, audiences that really respond. And we're now going to have the post-show discussion.
Yeah.
We've been telling everyone, we want you to vote yes or no. This is the real yes, no vote.
Yeah.
Did the mother do the right thing? So we're going to go and have that conversation now with the audience.
All right. Thanks for talking to us.
Thank you for inviting me.